Hello, guys. Welcome back to The Dark Side of the Zodiac in Relationships. Today I'll be talking about the dark side of the Scorpio woman. Let's get started. Okay, here we have an emotionally challenged woman who's been searching and seeking high and low for that ideal mate all of her life. This is the woman who is a go-getter. She goes after exactly who it is that she needs or she feels she needs and wants in her life. And once she spots this guy and she has that instant connection, you know, the sort of meeting of the minds type thing and that sexual connection right off, well, that's when she makes her approach. And she usually wins because she's good. And this is not the woman who's willing to wait around for that whole dating process. No, she just gets in and get right to it, which means it doesn't take you long to realize that not only is this lady, this female, the Scorpion Queen, is really good in bed and she really loves sex, is that she's really interested in you. And then this is where it all begins. Okay, here we have a woman who is relentless when she's trying to get her mate. Okay, this is the woman who is going to track you down, do whatever it is to get you to succumb to her. And when you have done so, game on. The Scorpion woman is the one woman in the zodiac that knows how to be in a relationship. She knows what it should entail and how it should be. She knows how to give love. And unfortunately, she has the tendency to fall for the wrong type of guys. And this is the one thing that brings out that dark side, that negative energy in her relationships. And when she gets with this wrong guy, she has a bit of a superiority complex. And with that, she needs you to put her on a pedestal. But if your partner can't afford a pedestal because he's probably unemployed or he has less than, he doesn't have, you know, the education that you do, or he doesn't make as much as you do, he's a bit of a bad guy. How can you have those expectations from someone who doesn't have, you know, that to give? It's impossible. And then this brings out that controlling nature you have, and you can be like the puppet master, you know, controlling her prey, dictating the relationship, because you know that you are the educated one and you probably make more, or you have more of an ego and esteem than your partner does. And when you do this, not only are you controlling, you become possessive. And it doesn't take very long for the partner to realize that she's extremely jealous and possessive. If you so much as look at another being, this sets off a trigger, and she's protective, but at the same sense, she's possessive, which means you're not going anywhere anytime soon. Now, what she does to get her partners is that she opens you up. She needs to know your darkest secret. She needs to know everything it is about you, and with that, it makes her a super duper snooper. She's always investigating, and she's so suspicious, and she's watching you. She's watching your every move. She's waiting and watching. So if you happen to leave your phone lying down unlocked, she'll check it. And if she sees something or she smells that perfume on your shirt, she'll become suspicious. She'll wait. But then she tightens the rope. And with that, you may seem as though you're so restricted, and she's going to set deadlines for you, and she becomes not even the man in the relationship. She becomes a monster. She's like Satan's sister. She's your worst nightmare. If you've hurt this woman and she's fallen deep and hard for you, you've got problems. And if you are that brave soul or thing, and you try to get away, you have even bigger problems. Because the one thing about this woman is when she's so emotionally involved is that she has a tendency to become obsessed. Not fantasize like some of the other signs in the zodiac and then just move on. She wants to participate in her obsession, which leads to stalking. She may stalk you on social media or sit outside of your workplace or, you know, pop up to your place unannounced, sit out, crazy things that that can scare a partner off. The reason for this is she's not really insecure. It's just that she has a hard time opening up and revealing her, you know, her deepest emotions and how she truly feels about a partner. So by showing her partner that she's possessive, in her mind, that's showing, hey, I really care about you and our relationship. But to the partner, it's like, no, and you're scaring me, and what's wrong with you? You're crazy. He or she may see it differently. Controlling does not mean I love you. Becoming destructive does not mean I love you, and even violent at times. This does not say I love you. It says, hey, and I want to scare the hell out of you so you don't go anywhere. And that's not going to keep the mate. And this is why you find yourself in relationships over and over again. You have to open up, let your partner in, express yourself exactly how you feel and what you expect in a mate and what you will and what you will not take. You can't do it after your partner commits a crime and then tortures the partner because you're good at torturing your mate for a very long time. That's not healthy. That's not going to keep them. Okay, so if you are trying to date the Scorpion woman, get her to open up and reveal her darkest, you know, secrets, because she has many of them, and how she genuinely feels about you, okay? And that is all for the dark side of the Scorpion woman in the relationship. Thank you so much for joining me. Until next time, take care.